Welcome everyone, this is Arthur Moore. Today we're going to talk about a very powerful combo, Final Cut Pro and Command Post. Let's start.
Okay, so first of all, what the hell is Command Post? Well, believe it or not, Command Post is a free extension for Final Cut Pro. It allows you to have many new functions that you couldn't even have before, like Spotlight Search for Final Cut Pro, movable markers, multiple saved effects and transition that you can apply with one button, and much, much more. In the video that is suggested to you right now, I talked about how Command Post is great when combining with Loop Deck Plus, a hardware console that can work with Final Cut Pro.
So I know many of you want me to talk about the connection between Loop Deck and Command Post, and I will. But first I want to talk about a few features that will save you tons of time, even if you don't have any hardware.
So many people have asked me, how do I get this little timeline? Okay, so this is how. After you install Command Post, you go to Preferences, and in the Final Cut Pro section, you click on Show Timeline in Viewers.
You have a small bar that represents your whole timeline. Doesn't matter where you are. You could be zoomed in and it still shows your whole timeline. Okay, this next one is a fun one. How many times you've put a marker in the wrong place and now you have to delete it, you have to go to the right place, put it there, and it's just tedious. Why those little annoying things can't just move? Well, if you go to Preferences and press on Movable Markers and you copy this command and paste it in your terminal, it will give you movable markers. Now your markers can fly. Oops! Be careful not to delete them. Okay, the next feature is gonna save you incredible amount of time. How many times you were editing, you knew exactly what you wanted to do, but the path there was slowing you down. For example, let's say I wanted to apply an effect on this image. Let's say it's the flipped, right? I wanted to flip the image. What if, as soon as it came to your mind, you could just apply it? This is where this amazing feature comes in. You just activate this console, and you write the name of the effect that you want to apply. Boom, you're done. Amazing. It works with transitions, it works with titles, just write whatever you want, it will apply it immediately. So to make it work, you go to Shortcuts, you choose Final Cut Pro, and it's called Activate Console. You can choose what buttons you want to press for this to be activated. This is like Spotlight Search for Final Cut Pro. Amazing time saver. And it's free. By the way, if we're already talking about saving time, did you know that if you press on Index and have that thing just on, Final Cut Pro becomes much slower? I don't know why, it's kind of a bug, I guess, but if that thing is on, everything is slower. I don't know if Apple is aware of it, but when I discovered it, it blew my mind. Just turning this off will make your Final Cut Pro way faster. Just letting you know. Okay, let's talk about Loop Deck and Command Post. Since I released the video, they updated the software and now they support Loop Deck in the app itself. You don't even need to do anything crazy. It's just click on the button you want to change, put the function, and it's done. You don't need to do anything else. But for some reason, since the update, the whole thing is way slower. All the wheels are very, very laggy. So I wouldn't recommend to put any functions on the wheels. You can put anything you want on the buttons, but in the wheels themselves, I wouldn't put any commands from Command Post because it's very, very laggy. You can still use the wheels in the actual original app from Loop Deck. For example, I made my big wheel to change the size of the thumbnails. It's very comfortable. I needed a lot of time, so it's cool. Many people have asked me, how do they apply my settings in Command Post? Since everything became very laggy, I don't actually recommend to use my settings because everything was with the wheels there. But in case they fix it, I still want to show you how to do it. You go to settings, you open the user settings, and you just paste my folders into this. All right, that's it for today. If you want to see more videos about Final Cut Pro, they're suggested to you right now. If you like this video, like it. If you want to see more, subscribe. That's it. Thank you for watching. Yeah, that's what I forgot. Thank you for watching.